Hello and welcome to the video where we'll be discussing the solution of a numerical in the topic of Simpson's one-third rule with half stations. So we have already discussed in the last video about the question. We have a vessel here, all the data is given, and I have also drawn a representative figure just to show you idea of how these half stations are taken and how these station numbering is done, and the difference, please remember the difference in the answer is you have to take the stations in the reverse order, that is 0 will come here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so this will be half, this will be 5.5. So this is how the numbering has to be done in your answer when you write the answer, but again the value of the answer as far as solution is concerned is not going to change whether it is this way or that way. So let us start the solution. Now it is very important that you draw a table. A table has to be constructed for solving any question in Simpson's rules. So how the table is constructed? First we will take the station numbering. As we have seen in the figure, we have seven stations starting from 0 to 6. As you must know, the convention says the station numbering has to start from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And again, as per the question, we have a half station in the forward end and aft end. So that is why half and 5.5. I have shown it in a different color so that you understand this is a half station. So in the next column, we have the data given in the question, the half ordinates at each of these stations. So the half ordinates given as 0, 4.88, 6.71, 7.31, etc. And the half station data they have given as 2.13, 3.35. So that one also we are taking. And you can see it is in synchronous. The data is in synchronous. You can see it is increasing from 0. It is increasing, increasing, increasing. And from here it is decreasing, decreasing, decreasing. So data is in synchrony. Now let us take the Simpson's multipliers. Now this is one section where always students have confusion. When we have a question of half stations, how do we take the Simpson's multipliers? This is a doubt usually all questions, all students have. Many students make mistakes here. So let me explain to you a very simple method by which we can easily write down the Simpson's multipliers. In this question, regardless of whether we have half stations or not, in a first column here, we can simply write the Simpson's multipliers for one third rule, starting from 1, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, 1. So just in the first column, just simply write down the Simpson's multipliers. Now in the next column, let us identify regions with half stations. You can see here 0, half, 1. This is one region of half station, and 5, 5.5, 6. This is another region of half station. Okay. Whereas other regions you can take 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. These are regions of full stations. So here I have identified 0, half, 1 as one region of half station, 5, 5.5 and 6 as another region of half station. So once I have identified the half station region, simply divide the value of Simpson's multipliers by 2 in the region of half stations only. So 1 becomes half, 4 becomes 2, 2 becomes 1, and here 2 becomes 1, 4 becomes 2, 1 becomes half. All other Simpson's multipliers in full station region to be kept as it is. So I hope you have understood the second step of the column. And in the third step, where we will get the final value of the Simpson's multipliers. In the boundary region which forms between half station and full station. So from 0 to 1, we have half station. From 1 to 2, we have full station. So this is a boundary. In this boundary, we need to add a half. Okay. Similarly here, 1 to 2 is full station, 2 to 3 full station, 3 to 4 full station, 4 to 5 full station. But 5 to 5.5 is half station. So this becomes a boundary. 5 becomes a boundary. So at 5, again, here we add 1. So this column will be your final Simpson's multipliers. So actually in your answer, when you write down the answer, you are only supposed to write this column. That is why I put A and B in bold. it's better that you don't write these or you strike these off, because it should not be part of evaluation. This will be your final value of Simpson's multipliers in your answer. But in order to arrive at this, it will be better if you can follow this method which I told you. You will very easily get the Simpson's multipliers without any confusion. So in the next column, we find the area function. So A into B, that is what we find of area function. A is this column, B is this column. When we multiply that at each and every station, we will get, we can find out sum of this, that is sigma A, that is 97.83. So once we get sigma A, then we can find out the formula of water plane. It is H by 3 into sigma A, that is the area of water plane, because we are taking half ordinates, we have to multiply with 2. 2 by 3 into H is 90 divided by 6, that is 97.83, which we have got last slide. So we will get the area of water plane. The first part of your answer is done, 978.3 meter square. Now the question is to find out the change in draft when we are adding a mass. So let us first find out the TPC. We know the formula of TPC, the tons per centimeter immersion is 1.025 into area of water plane by 100. So once I substitute these values, I will get the value of TPC as 10.0275 units, that is tons per centimeter. So once that is known, it has been mentioned that 153 tons is added to the vessel. So for 1 centimeter, 10.0275 tons is to be added. So for 153 tons, I will have a change in draft of 15.258 centimeters. Simple logic. I hope you have understood this. So from this, with this, half of the answer is over. Now, in order to find out our next step is to find out the center of flotation of the vessel, which will be nothing but the centroid of the water plane area. So the first step is, in this table, we need to add a new column which is called liver. Now, again, this is another confusion all the students have, because you can take a liver in many ways. In this particular question, I have taken liver from aft. So that is why the value of 0 is coming in the aft. And for this reason, the answer, that is the final position of central flotation I will get, will be from the aft. So I have to take full livers at full stations and half livers at half stations. So 0.5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5.5 and 6. It's 5.5 here and 6. This will be the liver. Again, if you don't understand what is liver, it is simply the distance of H. This is 1H, 2H, 3H, 4H, 5H, 6H, half H, 5.5H. It is simply the number of values of H we are taking from a reference. In this case, we are taking a reference from aft. You can also always take a reference from forward also. So in this question, actually, the question they have given is the half ordinates from forward. So they have given from forward. So I am actually taking liver from forward, because here the value of 0 represents forward. I'm taking liver from forward. The next step is I take moment function, that is A into B into C. So if I take the moment function at each station, I will get this value. And I need to add these values, I will get sigma m. Sigma m will be the sum of all the moments, that is a moment I will get by multiplying these two columns which I have put in this color. This I will get sigma m. So once I get sigma m, the distance of center of flotation from aft, that is what is asked. So we can find the value by substituting this formula, sigma m into h by sigma a. So the value which we got, 306.7 into 15 by 97.83, 47.025 will be the value which we get. So 90 minus 47.025, this will be the way in which we can get the final answer, and the final answer, as you can calculate, will be 42.975. So 42.975.